Hi and welcome to today's video. Today we're going to be looking at the Edexcel AS Level Biology Unit 1. We're going to start off with the transport around the body, and today's objectives are we're going to look at why animals have a heart and a mass transport system, so it's our circulatory system, and we're going to look at the limits of diffusion. Okay, so to start us off, we need to remember that with metabolism, most of the chemical reactions actually occur in the interior of a cell. So therefore, the actual size of a cell is going to affect the rate at which these reactions take place. Okay, and a few things to remember in terms of the exchange between the cell and its environment is that the surface of a cell, so the cell membrane, actually controls what enters and leaves the cell. And also that cells with a larger surface area can obviously exchange more materials. Okay, so what we're going to try and do now is work out the surface area to volume ratio of these three following cubes. Now you should be able to work out the surface area and also the volume as well. So when we have a look at it, the surface area of this small cube is 6 mm². The medium one is 24 mm, and obviously the larger square is 96 mm. And if you don't know how to calculate the surface area of a cube, especially, it's just you work out the area of one side, then you times it by 6. The volume is three-dimensional, so you're going to times these three numbers together. So the volume for this small cube is 1 mm³. The middle one, it's 8 mm³. And for the large square, or the large cube, I should say, it's 64 mm³. Now, because it's a ratio, you're just basically going to divide the surface area by the volume, and that gives you a ratio of 6:1. The medium one is 3:1, and the largest one is 1.5:1. So what this is showing is that the volume is actually increasing faster than the surface area. But wait, why is that a bad thing? Well, cells which are smaller have a much larger surface area to volume ratio. So just like this image of an amoeba here, it can move things into and out of its the center of a cell simply by diffusion. Much larger cells and larger organisms have obviously got a much smaller surface area to volume ratio. Therefore, diffusion is too slow. So therefore, the cells are limited by what they can actually do. So they need some sort of mass transport system in order to be able to get the nutrients from its environment into the cells so that it can carry out those basic metabolic reactions. And to do that, it uses, as I said before, its mass transport system and also specialist organs as well. So to summarize the first part, you can see that as organisms get larger, the surface area to volume ratio becomes smaller. Therefore, the exchanges with the environment become too slow. And we can use the calculation, or we can use Fick's law, to actually calculate the rate at which diffusion occurs. Now, we've basically done that where we looked at those three cubes. So basically, Fick's law revolves around three factors that affect diffusion. So that's the concentration gradient, the surface area, and also the thickness of the exchange surface. So if we apply this particular calculation to this cube, you can see that the rate at which O2, or oxygen, reaches the center of a cube is going to be a product of the ratio of the surface area compared to the volume. So therefore, there's a need for a mass transport system to carry substances around the organism. So some features of some common mass transport systems: you need a system of vessels that carry substances around the organism. You need a way of making sure that those substances are moved in the right direction. You need a means of moving the materials fast enough, and you also need a suitable transport medium. So in humans, the mass transport system is the circulatory system, and the specialized exchange organs include things like the lungs and the digestive system as well. Okay, so that concludes this short presentation. Hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to keep a lookout for some